And you can, you're empathetic. You know what they're thinking and feeling. It's almost like mind reading. But you have, when you know your product and you've spoken to enough people, you hear the same questions, the same verbiage all the time. And if you let the prospect control you, with the prospect has a great system, as I always say, they want a ton of free information. And what you have to do is when they ask a question, you have to first stroke and nurture them and then convert it into your question. They'll forget their question and you just take it and you just refinagle it and say, ask me a question. Ask me anything. Sky blue. Why is Perrier in a green bottle? Anything you want.
What are you having for dinner?
You know, oh, wow. You know, that's a great question. Thank you for asking. Oh my gosh. Now, what you must have asked that for a reason. Share that with me, Mr. Brian. Why did you bring that up just now? It's only 2 o'clock here. Well, why is my dinner on your mind right now? I'm just curious. Help me out.
Oh, because right now I haven't had that figured out.
Okay, but you must have asked about my dinner. Why are you so curious about what I eat? I'm just share that with me just for a moment. Help me out.
Oh, I mean, you're very healthy and you look way young for your age. That's why.
Thank
So
you.
I'm just
Flattery will
curious.
get you everywhere with me. Okay, good. See, what am I doing? What am I? So that was good role play, actually. What did I really did I really find out what he was thinking by turning a question and into another question? See, what would the amateur do? Gee, what are you having for dinner tonight? Oh, we're having what are we having today? We're having sausage and pepper sandwiches tonight. It's in the crock pot right now. Smells so good in this house. Can you imagine? You know, all the sausages, sweet and hot sausages, all the red and green and yellow peppers in there and onions, and they're cooking in a red tomato sauce gravy in this huge crock pot. And you take it and you put it on a nice crispy a baguette, with a little crunchy on the outside, soft, and you pour it all in there. And you can eat, hold it in your hand, but it's a mess. It goes down your arm, or you can cut it with a knife. And I like to put on a little bit of fresh Parmesan cheese. Just a little bit of grate, a little Parmesan cheese, and a nice glass of, I like red wine with a little Pinot Noir, a California Pinot. And you're biting it and chewing it, and the sausage and the peppers and the onions and the sauce. And okay, what's in your mind right now?
Dinner.
Yeah. I just put my dinner into your head.
Yeah.
You guys.